What's up, guys? We're back. We're going to cut this thing down to the Sweet 16. We already did the first half of the bracket, leaving us with The Sopranos, The Wire, True Detective, and Game of Thrones in the HBO category, and then Stranger Things, Narcos, Black Mirror, and The Marvelous Miss Maisel in the streaming category. Today, we dive back into the network sitcoms and the best of the rest. Let's just kick this thing off with a big matchup. The Office, the one seed, versus its fellow NBC Thursday night lineup companion, Community. And I'm happy to announce that Community advances. The lovable underdog moves on.
Lives.
Hey, Troy sneezes like a girl.
And how about I pound you like a boy? That didn't come out right.
Why don't you all just leave him alone with his cute little baby sneezing?
You're not my mother.
She's not?
29 seconds.
And remember, guys, Community is newly on Netflix. So make sure you check that out if you haven't already. I'm currently watching it again, one of my favorite shows ever. But moving on, we've got Cheers versus Modern Family. I went with Cheers here, but I was outvoted by David St. Martin and Andrew Volpe. The classic loses, perhaps poetically, to a show called Modern Family. Modern Family moves on.
Okay, knock it off. It is time for some farm justice. Back home, when we have two alpha bulls, we lock them in a pen and let them fight it out. This is between Manny and Luke. Come on, let's go. Yow! Yow! Oh, and help yourself to a gingerbread person. They're both gluten and gender free.
Oh. Isn't they a cutie?
Okay, two classic sitcoms, one appreciated by critics in its time, and the other with an ever-growing appreciation. Now, let me just say this. Both Frasier and Seinfeld are two of my favorite shows of all time, period, any genre. So it wasn't an easy decision for me by any means, but I went with Seinfeld. DSM went with Seinfeld, and Andrew Volpe went with Frasier. But it wasn't enough. Seinfeld takes this one.
My back is killing me.
Of course, because of that wallet. You got a filing cabinet under half of your ass.
This is an organizer, a secretary, and a friend.
Look at you. You're on a slant.
Finally, Arrested Development versus Scrubs. Arrested Development was one of the smartest shows of all time. Critically acclaimed. It has a cult following, great cast, great writers. But for some reason, these guys just love Scrubs. I don't know. Now, I like Scrubs, but I didn't expect it to make it past Friends. I certainly didn't expect it to make it past Arrested Development. Could Scrubs dethrone Seinfeld next round? Who knows, man? It's the Cinderella story of the whole bracket. At this point, anything's possible, but at least for now, Scrubs moves on.
Perhaps an accidental collision. Then a simple touch on the shoulder. And just like that, you have a patient in trouble.
Chinatown is awesome.
I want that bird gone.
Okay, so on to the final quadrant, the best of the rest. And we start things off with a matchup between Breaking Bad and Better Call Saul, which is, of course, a spinoff of Breaking Bad. Well, the original reigns supreme, a clean sweep, one of just two clean sweeps in this region. There were none in the sitcom region this time around. Congrats to Breaking Bad. Moving on.
It ceases to exist without me. No, you clearly don't know who you're talking to, so let me clue you in. I am not in danger, Skyler. I am the danger. A guy opens his door and gets shot, and you think that of me? No. I am the one who knocks.
And their opponent? Mad Men. Easily the two best AMC shows of all time. They'll be squaring off next round. I think a lot of people, if you look at this bracket, kind of saw this matchup coming eventually, and it's going to be a doozy. You know, Volpe went with Atlanta. I happen to love Atlanta, just not as much as I love Mad Men. Don Draper and company are on to the Sweet 16.
Teddy told me that in Greek, nostalgia literally means the pain from an old wound. It's a twinge in your heart, far more powerful than memory alone. This device isn't a spaceship. It's a time machine.
Okay, the epic cartoon matchup. This is another one that people were excited for. One that people everywhere have been debating for years, The Simpsons versus South Park. Which one's better? And this is our second of two clean sweeps in the region. The Simpsons takes it. 3-0. I'm still in the process of binging that show, by the way. Halfway through season 5 now. And it's brilliant, man. Which is not, you know, exactly a hot take. But it's crazy how relevant and hilarious these jokes still are today, considering they were written in the early to mid-90s.
Hello, my name is Mr. Burns. I believe you have a letter for me.
Okay, Mr. Burns. What's your first name?
I don't know. Great plan, Bart.
And to complete our round of 16, Rick and Morty versus Always Sunny. Rick and Morty takes it. No drama needed. I went with Always Sunny, but David Simard and Andrew Volpe did not, which sets us up for another massive cartoon battle next time around, by the way. You're going to have The Simpsons versus Rick and Morty, another sort of more modern show versus an older show, even though obviously The Simpsons is famously still on, 31 seasons. But yeah, Rick and Morty takes this one.
Hey, are you tired of real doors cluttering up your house where you open them and you actually go somewhere and you go into another room? Get on down to real fake doors. That's us. Fill a whole room up with them. See, watch. Check this out. Won't open. Won't open. Not this one. Not this one. None of them open. FakeDoors.com is our website, so check it out for a lot of really great deals on fake doors.
And that's it. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys will continue to follow along as we narrow this thing down to the greatest show of all time. We'll be back with the Sweet 16. I'll probably do it all in one video since obviously the matchups are more limited. So we'll cut the entire field of 16 down to 8 in the next video. So make sure you guys watch, subscribe, rate, review, tell a friend about this. And I guess most importantly, watch the shows we're talking about, because if it's made it this far, chances are it's pretty damn good. All right. Thanks. Peace, guys.